Well, so far that actually looks pretty lethal.
Hi fellas, Matthew here from Crooks Cabinet Makers. Well, today I've got a really, really special tool to introduce to you guys and a pretty great project coming up to do with it. So without further ado, let's crack on.
So this is the mighty Hitachi circular saw. So we've got a blade width on this thing, 235. This particular model is over 20 years old, still functioning good as gold. The power on this one is 1750 watts. The new version comes with 1600 watts and 2000 watts. So this is somewhere between the two. The price of this saw brand new is 150 quid for the 1600 watt and 230 quid for the 2000 watt. The big question is, what do I want to do with it? Well, when this was built, Hitachi had some holes in there. So that occurs to me that those holes are just the right size to put a bolt through. So let's see if I can make this into a table saw. So the first thing I've got to do is work out the width of this saw. So it's quite easy. Just gonna use my engineering square and put that to a point on here and mark off a pencil line. Put that one on there and work out where that comes to. So now I can't really fit my pencil. I can't fit my pencil down here and mark accurately. I'm gonna be about 2 or 3 mil out. So all I'll do is I'll mark on the back edge of that. My saw completely out of the way. Mark there. Mark off nicely. And then get a measurement. So when I measure something, it's real easy. I come from the 100 mil mark and then read the measurement there. So I've got a 100 mil mark and I'll make that to be 3, 6, 8. So 3, 6, 8 minus 100 is 2, 6, 8. So now I need to measure the inside of my unit to see if I've got that space. And I've got exactly 2, 6, 8. By a complete fluke, I can fit this saw into this part of the bench base underneath. So I've taped over this area because pencil line never shows up too well on ply. So I've taped over this where I think I need to cut it. And now what I need to do is show you that. And that's the shape I've got. But now what I want to do is just take some corners on there. Okay, so that should work. Little bit of bar edge to get off underneath there. The
It's a very nice cut. It's actually also procrastinating because I am not sure whether it fits or not. Oh dear. Well, now I don't want to say anything too soon, but is that first time? Now, I've marked the position of the holes with a pen. So now I need to take this out, drill out, and put these threaded grub screws in there. So, semi-failure here at this point. These ones at the front, I just couldn't get enough movement between the holes. And I didn't want to drill these holes out again to make these holes larger. So rather than damage this saw, I just clipped the front end in with a block of wood. So I know what you're thinking, this is not your usual excellence. So perhaps we can just call it a prototype. And this whole bench is a prototype anyway, so now it's time to turn it over and put some material through it. Enjoy! Well, so far that actually looks pretty lethal. There we go. Bit of nasty damage there. Bit of a shame. Never mind. It's such a great cut, I'm so happy with it. Anyway, so I've got improvements to make on it and I shall do those over the next few days. So I hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching. Stay safe in the workshop. Have a nice day.
You are such a blogger.